वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स टू द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड लिटरेचर कोड 184 सीबीएसई क्लास 10 फर्स्ट टर्म सिलेबस. टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द सेकंड चैप्टर नेल्सन मंडेला. दिस इज पार्ट 3. टू वीडियोस हैव ऑलरेडी बीन अपलोडेड. चेक दोज वीडियोस, देन यू वुड बी एबल टू लर्न बेटर एंड देन गो फॉर दिस वीडियो. लेट अस रिकॉल व्हाट वी हैड लर्नड. वी लर्नड दैट This chapter is the part of the autobiography of Nelson Mandela, which is titled Long Back to Freedom. He was against apartheid. And what is apartheid? This system during this system, the whites were considered superior and blacks were not given rights. And then we talked about that how did they win the election? And then Nelson Mandela became the first South African black president. And where did the ceremony take place? It took place in lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Buildings in Pretoria. This day was 10th May and he was along with his daughter Zenani. Mr. D. Clark took the oath as the second deputy president and Thabo Mbeki as the first deputy president. Then it was the turn of Nelson Mandela to take oath. In his oath, very clearly he stated that the soil of South Africa will never face any kind of discrimination anymore. Then he talked about military, that the military was also showing him respect for this new installation of government and being the president of South Africa. So then Nelson Mandela was talking about the two national anthems that were sung on that day. He was also referring to the sacrifices that were made by the African patriots to bring this day. He was saying that before his birth, this apartheid had been installed. But after his birth, when he has been 80 now, this system has been abolished. Then he wanted to thank the African patriots who sacrificed their lives to abolish apartheid system. And he was feeling grieved that he is not able to thank them. Then he was talking about that what is courage, that he has learned from these people, that courage is not the absence of fear, but courage is winning over the fear. He was also talking about love and hate, that if a person can be taught how to hate, he can also be taught how to love, because love is more natural than hate. Then he was talking about two of the obligations that every person has to fulfill in his day, in his life. The first obligation is towards his family. That means towards his family, he has to serve his family. And the other obligation is towards his country. He was saying this thing that it was impossible for a black person in South Africa to fulfill both the obligations if they want to fulfill the second obligation towards their own community and own people. Because he was talking about himself, that when he was fighting against apartheid, he could not do the duty towards his family. He had to live a life of secrecy and rebellion. And he could not fulfill the duties towards his family. He could not fulfill his obligation as a son, brother, father, or a husband. Let's continue. What is there on this page? Let me zoom it. Okay. Now he is saying that how did this hunger came to me? How and when did I realize that I am not free? Because as a child takes birth, he does not know whether he is free and what is freedom meant to him. So he is saying that when I was born with a hunger, I was not born with a hunger to be free. I was born free, free in every way I could know. What is freedom for a kid? Just to enjoy around his parents. So that was the freedom for me too. Nothing else. I want freedom to run in the fields near my mother's hut. I wanted freedom to swim in the clean stream, clean water that ran through my village. I wanted freedom to roast mealies. Mealies are the sweet corns. I wanted to roast mealies and eat them under the stars. I wanted to ride the broad backs of slow moving bulls. I wanted to take ride of bulls. So this was freedom for me as a child. And as long as I obeyed my father and I followed the customs of my tribe, abided means I followed the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or God. I was not troubled. I did not know that I have not been guaranteed some freedom. My people are getting deprived of some freedom because this was the freedom for me as a child. Now, he would talk about the freedom at different stages of his life. He's saying that it was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion. Then I realized that it is an illusion. It is a cheat. I am being cheated. I do not know that this is not freedom. I grew up, I realized that the boyhood freedom that I used to think about, the freedom that he is talking about in this paragraph, is an illusion. When I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, when I became young, I realized that my freedom has been taken away from me. And I began to fight against for it. That hunger increased. At first, I wanted freedom as a student. I wanted freedom only for myself. And he's saying that I did not want freedom for anybody else. I wanted freedom for myself only. Fine. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself. The transitory means short-lived freedoms of being able to stay out at night. These were the short-lived freedom. These were the small freedoms that I wanted. I wanted to stay out at night. I wanted to read what I wanted to. I wanted to go wherever I wanted to. Later, as a young man in Johannesburg, I earned for basic and honorable freedom of achieving my potential. And what was the freedom for me when I was a young man? I wanted these freedoms. What I want, I earned for basic and honorable freedom. And what were those? I wanted to achieve my potential, that whatever I deserve, I should earn. Second, of earning my keep. I wanted to keep my earnings, of marrying to the person, to the lady that I like, to have a family. Fine. I don't want that any freedom to be obstructed by law. If the law is telling me that being a black, I am not allowed to come there, I was not ready to accept it. So freedom meant different things for me at different stages of my life. And it kept on changing its meaning too. Fine. I think you understood it. Fine. So I'm moving to the next slide. But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, I realized that I am not the only one whose freedom has been taken away. My brothers and sisters were also not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that has been curtailed, but the freedom of everyone who looked like me. That means every black person was not given the freedom. That is when I joined National African Congress. And that was the day when I realized this thing, that I joined this party. And that is when the hunger of my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom of my people. Then the freedom was not only limited to me. It had changed its meaning. I wanted a freedom for my whole community, for my whole group of black people. It was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their life with dignity and self-respect that animated my life. Animate means to give shape. So he's saying that this desire that I want freedom for my people, I want dignity, I want respect, that my people should also earn respect. And this hunger in me shaped my life. And I transformed. This is again very interesting and important. What is he talking about? He's saying that this feeling only transformed a frightened young man into a bold one. I was a frightened man. I became a bold one. I was a law-abiding attorney. He was a lawyer. And he became a criminal because he was going against the law. The law was also supporting only white people. So he was a lawyer. He went against the law. That turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home. I loved my family a lot. But this hunger made me leave my family and to live a life of secrecy. That forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. I loved my life. I wanted to enjoy everything in my life. But I was living a life of monk. I'm not no more virtuous and self-sacrificing man than the next man. But I found that I could not enjoy the poor and the limited freedom I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. You know that? Do you remember? In the last slide, we learned that he was enjoying those transitory freedoms for himself. But when he realized that his people are not free, he was not enjoying those transitory and limited freedoms. And he realized that freedom is indivisible. We cannot divide freedom. I cannot change the definition of freedom for somebody. If I'm saying that I freedom for me is that I want to go anywhere I like to. I wanted to get the job according to my own capabilities. This is my freedom. And if the definition of freedom is changing from one person to another, that means that is not a real freedom. So freedom is indivisible. You cannot divide the freedom. And then he realized that I do not want those transitory and small freedoms. If there is a chain on any person of me, any people, any person of my community, that is a chain on me. If somebody's freedom is taken away, that means my freedom will also be taken away. The chains of any person of mine would be a chain on me also. Chain means here, if somebody's freedom is taken away, somebody from my community, if their freedom is taken away, that means my freedom is also taken away. So I won't be able to enjoy those transitory freedoms. Okay, moving to the next slide. This is the last chance of the chapter, but again, very important. This is one of the pics that I found, that Abdul Kalam was there and Nelson Mandela ji was there, and they were meeting with each other. Okay, they had a communication with each other. Two great people, two great personalities. Okay. And now what is he saying in the last? He said that this was the hunger that made me go for fight to go against apartheid. Okay. Now he's saying that I knew that oppressor must be liberated just surely as oppressed. Oppressor is a person who is suppressing somebody else, who is considering superior to himself. He's saying a person who is considering himself superior, he also want freedom just as the oppressed. For example, if I am beating somebody, I am the oppressor. Fine. And the person whom I am beating is oppressed. So both needs freedom. And how do both need freedom? Let's find out how. What kind of freedom is he talking about for oppressor who is suppressing others, who has been beating others? A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. If I do not want something, for example, I hate somebody, then only I would be doing wrong to them. Why would I do wrong to somebody? That means my heart is full of hatred. My heart is in the prison of hate. My heart is locked behind the bars of prejudice. Prejudice means not liking others. And narrow-mindedness. I'm not able to think beyond a certain point. Fine. So a person who is oppressing others, is his heart is full of hatred. And I am not truly free if I am taking away somebody else's freedom. If I'm taking away your freedom, that means I am feeling insecure. I have fear of something in my mind. I hate you too much that I am not free from fear. Just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken away from me, if I have been ill-treated, I have not been guaranteed some freedom, that means I am not free. But if I'm taking somebody else's freedom, that means also that my heart is in the prison of prejudice. My heart is full of hatred towards somebody. This question is very, very, very important. The last line he says, which is the crux of the story, that says that the oppressed and the oppressor are alike and robbed of humanity. If you are ill-treated, if you are oppressed, your humanity will die will towards others. But if I am taking somebody else's freedom, that means I am already inhuman. And the freedom I'm taking away from somebody, that person will also become inhuman one day. So I'm robbing, I'm taking away their humanity. The oppressor and oppressed are same because their humanity has been robbed away from them. They have been looted away from them. They have been taken away from them. I hope you have understood the text. Please do read the text once again to have the better understanding. Now we will see some of the MCQs from the chapter. This is the extract based. The other one would be the open MCQs. Let's go with it. This is the first extract. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion, I realized that my freedom was an illusion only. When I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken away from me, I began to hunger for it. Then when I realized that my freedom has been taken away, that I began to get hungry for the freedom. At first, as a student, I wanted the freedom only for myself. The small freedom, the transitory freedoms of being able to stay out at night, read what I please and go where I chose. Later, as a young man in Johannesburg, I earned for the basic and ordinary freedom. But when I became young, I realized that I have not given the basic and honorable freedoms also. Okay, so this was the extract I explained to you earlier also. Again, I have told you, the thing is the first question, the title that best suits this extract is Freedom for Everyone, knowledge about freedom, significance of freedom, or realization of freedom? The answer would be significance of freedom. Next. Why do you think the speaker mentioned some freedoms as transitory? Why was he saying that some freedoms are short-lived? The freedoms are momentary and keep changing with time. The definition of freedom changes with the time. The definition of freedom is constant, but perspective differs. The way one looks at it is different. Freedom means different things to different people. Freedom is not that important after a certain age. This is A. Fine. I'm moving to the next one. Third question from the same extract that says, choose the option that best fits the usage of the word illusion. The way the word illusion has been used here, you have to tell the meaning of it. Fine. He was not able to get past the illusion. The illusion I experienced was quite intriguing. Intriguing means alluring. That was attracting me. A large mirror in the room creates an illusion. I was living under the illusion that this is possible. This is D part. The speaker says, at first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself. Why do you think he only thought about himself? Why he was getting selfish and he was thinking only about himself? He did not want to think about the freedom denied to others. He least cared about the freedom which is not given to others. He was being selfish and was only bothered about himself. He did not think that freedom denied to him was important to others. He did not realize that the freedom which is not given to him is important for others. D part to others as well. That means he did not know. This is D part again. Fine. Which says this thing that he could not realize that the freedom has been denied to others. He was too young to understand it. When he grew up, he realized it. Now the same extract, the last question of this extract. A part of the extract, A part of the extract has been paraphrased. This extract has been given a short summary of it. Choose the option that includes the most important solution to the blanks in the given paraphrase of the extract. What is this? The speaker's belief about freedom, since childhood proved false, since childhood he was considering what is freedom, it proved false in the later stage of his life. It was not until the speaker grew up to a young man when it dashed on him, when it arrived, desired, arrived. So B and C are going dawn, when it dawned on him that he was dash of freedom. He is deprived of freedom. And then he began desiring it. So when you would read the sentence, then you would be able to fulfill the answer. And the answer would be B part. Okay, moving on to the next one. Now, some open questions, open MCQs would be there from the text. First is, when was the inauguration day? 10th May, 10th March, 20th May, 20 March, A option. How many deputy presidents were elected? 2, 3, 1 or none? It is 2, first deputy and second deputy. Why did other countries broke off diplomatic relations with South Africa? Why the other countries had broken up the relations? White rulers, other countries are racial. It is a poor country, apartheid policy, very clearly stated. Third answer is D option, apartheid policy. Moving to the next slide. The spectacular array of South African jets was a display of, what were they displaying? Military precision, they were saying the accuracy, military loyalties to democracy, both one and two or none of the above. It would be C part, though it is written D, better be careful, both one and two would be the correct answer. What colors did the South African flag possess? A confusing question. Black, red, green, blue, gold. Black, red, yellow, blue, gold. Orange, black, yellow, blue, silver. Black, blue, violet, saffron, green. It is A part. Black, red, green, blue, gold. What unintended effect did the decades of oppression and brutality had? What is the unintended? What was not expected from it, but still it brought? The apartheid has brought something. It was not expected. And what was that? It created men of extraordinary courage, wisdom, and generosity, poverty and suffering, boycott from the foreign nations, or both two and three. It is the first part, A part. Fine. Moving to the next slide. The last slide. What did Mandela learn about courage? Again, important. It is absence of fear. It is triumph over fear, both one and two or none of the above. The answer would be B part. It is the triumph over fear. Triumph means victory. What are the main obligations in life? Obligation to people, obligation to family, obligation to God, both one and two, it would be D part. Okay? Both one and two. A man who takes away another's man freedom is white, a prisoner of hatred, criminal or rude, he's a prisoner of hatred, B part. Let's end up the MCQs. I never lose, I either win or learn. With this, we will end up the lecture. Hope you would understand. Please look for all the three parts, then the story and the question answers would be clear to you. Thank you. Stay tuned.